Hi, I'm Jeff, and I'm a senior analytic training consultant in SAS education. In this video, I'm going to introduce Model Studio for the Enterprise Miner user. Now, coming from the Enterprise Miner world is not a prerequisite for watching this video. Whether you've used Enterprise Miner or not, you're definitely going to learn some neat things about Model Studio. Before we jump into the video, let me talk to you just a little bit about the background of each of these two powerful tools. SAS Enterprise Miner is SAS's flagship data mining product, and it was invented over 20 years ago. It's built around SAS 9 technologies. That means the engine under the hood are SAS 9 procedures, but Enterprise Miner also comes with special procedures designed for Enterprise Miner to work with large data sets. Model Studio runs on SAS Via. SAS Via is the modern application for SAS that runs on the CAS server, and it uses Via procedures. CAS stands for Cloud Analytic Services, and it's the in-memory engine for SAS Via that works with data in-memory and runs in a massively parallel environment. Both tools are designed for building supervised predictive models, but they both have capabilities in data preparation, data exploration, feature engineering, unsupervised applications, model deployment, and more. Let's go ahead and jump into the video. For Enterprise Miner, the name of the game is efficiency. It's a point-and-click interface for building supervised models, and it takes care a lot of the mundane tasks that might take time or cause frustration if you're building your models by writing out code. Enterprise Miner can be installed on the desktop where there's no login needed, but its best application is at the enterprise level where it's a server-based tool where login's required, and that's what we have here. Here, the ID and password are automatically filled, so I'll click log on. Once we log on, that takes us to the Enterprise Miner welcome screen, where I can do a couple things, such as access the Enterprise Miner help menu. I can also create a new project, which I'll do later, and I can open all projects or recent projects. And I'll start by opening a pre-existing project. A list of the current projects is available, and I'll open the first one on the list, Advanced Predictive Models. I'll select it and click OK. So starting in the upper left-hand corner, we have what's called the project panel. Notice the name of the project is highlighted, Advanced Predictive Modeling. The window below that is called the Properties panel, and that gives you properties and other information about whatever's highlighted on the interface. Right now, since the name of the project is highlighted, we see information about the project, such as when it was created and the path for the project folders. Let's take a look at what this pre-built project contains. I'll expand the folder for data sources. And we can see that there are several data sources that are already included in the project. Suppose I wanted to take a look at the claim data source, maybe see what the columns are and their associated column metadata. I can right-click on claim, go to edit variables. Enterprise Miner likes opening new windows, and here we see a window that has the variables in the claim data source with their column metadata, the role and measurement level of each variable. Back in the project panel in the upper left-hand corner, maybe I want to take a look at the diagrams. Now, the diagrams are the level of organization where the work is actually done. Within the diagram, it contains a process flow. The process flow is constructed by connecting nodes together, and that's the analysis. I'll be covering that in more detail in another video. Let's see if there's any diagrams in our current project. I'll click the plus sign next to diagrams. And we see that there are several diagrams that currently exist. Let me go ahead and open one of them. I'll double click on claim. What that does is that activates the middle part of the interface, which is the diagram workspace. It also activated the tabs across the top, known as the SEMA tabs, sample, explore, modify, model, and assess. And you'll be hearing more about those in another video. Right now, it's a pretty simple diagram. It just has the data source claim included in it, which somebody manually brought into the diagram from the project panel. Now let me go ahead and show you how a new project is created in Enterprise Miner. We saw that on the initial welcome menu, we could create a new project from there, but I can also create a new project a couple of ways from the interface itself. I could use the file pull-down menu, go to File, New Project, or I can use that Starburst shortcut button, which is for new actions, and click the Starburst and go to New Project. For the desktop version of the software, creating a new project is a two-step process, but for the full server-based version, it's a four-step process, which is what we'll go through here. Step one is the SAS server where the processing will take place. Usually that's done upon installing the software. We don't need to make any changes there. I'll click next to go to step two, where I'll provide a name for the project, and I'll call this project YouTube. You could name it anything you want. And the SAS server directory is where certain project folders and files will be located once you get into the analysis. I'll pick a particular location on the local drive. I'll click Browse. I'll go to the D drive, and I'll select the folder called EM Projects. I'll just select that location and click OK. I click Next to go to step three. That's the location of the SAS folders, which again is defined upon installation. Don't need to make any changes there. I'll click Next. Step four is a summary of the project, and we'll click Finish. You see that the diagram workspace gets grayed out again. It's not active until we actually create a diagram. In the upper left-hand corner in the project panel, I'll click the plus sign next to data sources, and the folder doesn't expand because we have not created any data sources for this project yet. Again, you'll be seeing that in a future video. There's no diagrams, and I'd have multiple ways to create the diagram. I could use the File pull-down menu and go to File New Diagrams. I could use the shortcut button for new, that Starburst, and create a new diagram. But I'll create a new diagram by right-clicking on the Diagrams folder itself and then going to Create Diagram. I'll give it a simple name, My Diagram, and click OK. Notice once I've created a diagram, the diagram workspace is white and now active. The SEMA tools palette are available. And if I was ready to do some work, I'd need to create a data source and then I could build my process flow. Let's get ready to move over to Model Studio where I'll compare and contrast some of the things we've seen here. All right, before we jump into Model Studio, first we have to think about SAS VIA. Like all VIA products, Model Studio is a web-based application. So there's a specific URL to get to SAS VIA. And in this particular case, we're ready to log on. By the way, SAS VIA is more modern than Enterprise Miner, so it has more hosting options. You can have SAS VIA installed locally on your own hardware at your enterprise. It can be hosted in the cloud, or it can even run on third-party applications such as Amazon Web Services. All VIA products require login. Here the user ID and password are auto-filled, so I'll just click Sign In. Assumable Groups gives you the ability to take administrative privileges, and for our demonstration, that'll be fine. I'll just click Yes. Initially, when we log on, we go to SAS Drive, which is the hub to access all VIA applications. We want to go to Model Studio, so in the upper left-hand corner, I'll click that Applications menu, and I'll go to Build Models. You want to be a little bit careful there because the Applications menu describes the action that you want to perform, not the actual tool that you want to go to. I know I want to go to Model Studio, and the actions we'll perform there would be to build models. Now we're at the Model Studio Projects page, and in fact, notice the banner across the top. Clearly it says we're at Model Studio, where the action is to build models. We see some pre-built projects. Notice that under the project name, it says the type of project. For this particular computer, most of the projects are for text analytics, but there is one for data mining and machine learning. Notice also in the upper right-hand corner, there's a button to create a new project, and I'll do that later. Right now, let's kind of work our way and navigate through a pre-built project where I can compare and contrast some of the things we saw in Enterprise Miner. I'll double click to open the project called NYC Low Grade VD MML. Uh-oh, we see a red X. But actually, I knew that was coming. All VIA products work with data that's in memory. For this pre-built project, we use it in a class where the students will build the data before they get to the project. So for this teaching computer, our data set has been removed from memory. Notice that on that warning window, it says, check to make sure that the table is in memory. I know it's not, but that's okay. We can still navigate around and explore the project. So I'll just close that window. Different from Enterprise Miner, there's a couple of tabs across the top. Now, depending on what type of model you're building, whether it's text analytics, forecasting, or data mining and machine learning, the number of tabs across the top might be different. For data mining and machine learning, we have four tabs: data, pipelines, pipeline comparison, and insights. Right now, we're at the data tab, where we see the columns associated with the data and their metadata. And I'll talk more about the data tab in a future video as well. Let's take a look at pipelines. The pipelines for Model Studio are similar to the diagrams and process flows in Enterprise Miner. Here, a pipeline is a structured flow of analytic actions. For this pipeline, it starts with the data, we build a couple of models, and then we do some model comparison. Now, since the data is not in memory, if I tried to build another pipeline and run nodes, they would fail to run. Let's take a look at pipeline comparison. This is something in Model Studio that Enterprise Miner does not have. Imagine a scenario where we've built several pipelines and each pipeline has their champion model. Pipelines comparison kind of provides the champion of all champions. It defines the overall project champion model. In this case, the pipeline comparison tab only has one model. It's the logistic regression model from pipeline one. Let's take a look at the insights tab. Now, in this case, Enterprise Miner has something close, but it's not as detailed and it's not immediately available. In Enterprise Miner, there's something called the reporter node, which I can put into a diagram and it summarizes that one particular diagram. The insights tab, however, is a summary of the entire project. It summarizes the data set, it describes what the overall project champion model is, it even provides information such as the most common variables across all models. Now that we've taken a look and explored a pre-built project, let's go ahead and build one from scratch. From the current open project, I'm going to go back to the projects page. That's the horizontal lines right next to the name of the project. Now from the projects page, I'll click the button to create a new project. In Enterprise Miner, I created the project called YouTube. Why don't I go ahead and use the same name here? I can choose the project type: data mining and machine learning, text analytics, or forecasting. For our demonstration, data mining and machine learning will be sufficient. Now, here's where we're going to definitely begin to see more differences from Enterprise Miner. In Enterprise Miner, you create the project, and then you can add one or more data sources once the project is created. For Model Studio, you have to include a data source when you're creating the project, and each project can only be attached to one data source. Remember, the data is going to live in memory. Let's go ahead and see what we've got. Next to the data property, I'll click Browse. And in the upper left-hand corner, we see a tab for available. That shows me all of the data that's currently in memory. In a future video, I'll show you how to load data into memory if what you need's not readily available there. So in this case, I'll just use the one data set in memory, SAS VIA types. I'll highlight it and click OK. That brings us back to the new project window where I'll click Save. So now we're at the data tab in the new YouTube project. Notice that Model Studio is telling me right across the top, I have to have a role of target in order to run a pipeline. Model Studio is primarily used for building supervised machine learning models. It won't let you even move forward in the project without having a target variable. I'll go ahead and pick the variable interval and assign that to role of target. I'll click the checkbox next to the variable name. In the right-hand corner, the properties pane activates, where I'll change the role from input to target. The warning at the top goes away, and we're ready to proceed with the project. Let's take a look at what we get in the Pipelines tab. In the pipeline, automatically called Pipeline 1, notice the data is already included into that process flow. Now, again, that's different from Enterprise Miner. We'd need to manually bring data into a diagram in Enterprise Miner, but in Model Studio, since each project is assigned to one data source, that data node is automatically in the pipeline. Creating a new pipeline is pretty easy. I'm just going to click the plus sign next to pipeline one. I'll give it my pipeline for the name. I'll click save. We've got a new pipeline. The data node's already included. And I'll show you how to add nodes to that pipeline or build up the analysis in a future video. Well, I hope you liked that video on introducing Model Studio for the Enterprise Miner user. And whether you use Enterprise Miner or not, I hope you check out Model Studio. It's a pretty powerful tool. So be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Check out the additional resources down below, including links to blogs and other YouTube videos, and make sure you subscribe to the SAS Users channel. Until next time, this is Jeff. I'll see you later.